You're watching UNICEF television.
A new day begins for the children of the Traore family in the village of Djouliba in Mali. And with it comes the busy morning routine of getting ready for school.
In my day, we had no schools in the village, just Quranic education at the mosque. But now these children have the good luck to have a school here.
Just 15 years ago, there were no schools in Djouliba. In fact, this community had resisted the idea of formal education for decades. But today, there are three schools that are serving the specific needs of all of the children of the village. Each of the five Traore children attends classes. Five-year-old Arhama gets dropped off at an early childhood development center, or ECD. It caters to the community's preschoolers. Her brother, Yaya, who's 11, and sister, Nana, 8, go to the primary school, while the oldest children, 13-year-old Wassa and 15-year-old Musa, attend non-formal education classes, or NFE.
The three schools complement each other. The ECD center prepares the children for school. Then, when they're old enough, they attend the formal primary school. The NFE center is for those children who dropped out or who did not ever get the chance to go to school. By giving all of the children in the village the opportunity to attend one of these schools, this community is working to fight illiteracy.
This child-friendly, girl-friendly approach is part of a UNICEF-supported program to bring basic quality education to all children aged 3 to 18 in vulnerable communities. UNICEF supports the Ministry of Education at national, regional, and local levels, as well as teachers' academies and the communities themselves, to implement the child-friendly, girl-friendly model throughout Mali. Nearly half of Mali's 14.5 million people survive on less than a dollar a day. With such deprivation, 85% of children do not have access to basic social services, and more than half of the population is illiterate. Providing education for all is essential to help break the country's cycle of poverty and illiteracy. And that process begins with the ECDs.
There is a big difference between those children who attend ECD and those who do not. Those who came from the ECD are more sociable, active, and alert, and they have already developed school habits, so it is easy for them to adapt to school.
The early childhood development centers lay an important foundation for primary school and help minimize the chances that students will drop out. But the path to education here has not been an easy one. Like many rural areas in Mali, Djouliba is governed by Islamic tradition. It took time for the community to embrace an education that was non-religious. Now, the village sees children as agents of positive change.
Sending our children to school is good for the whole family. At school, they learn good habits, like washing hands, that we now practice at home.
Mm-hmm.